Hello everyone, welcome back to new video and I am Ranjit Krishna. Today's video will be in English because I want to make sure that this video should reach non-Malayalis too. We Keralites need your support. Today I am going to talk about Mullaperiyar Dam and the consequences if it collapses suddenly. The Mullaperiyar Dam, a masonry gravity dam situated on the Periyar River in Kerala, has been a subject of intense debate and concern for many years. Built in 1895 by the British, it stands at 53.66 meters, that is 176 feet, and holds a reservoir capacity of 443.23 million cubic meters. The dam, while historically significant and vital for irrigation in Tamil Nadu, poses a significant threat to the lives and livelihoods of millions if it were to collapse. This hypothetical scenario, though daunting, is important to explore as it emphasizes the political consequences and the need for protective and proactive measures. The Mullaperiyar Dam is over 125 years old and its structural integrity has been questioned numerous times. Originally constructed with lime surki mortar, a material that weakens over time, the dam's ability to withstand natural disasters like earthquakes has been a major concern. The dam is located in a seismic zone, adding to the vulnerability. Though various strengthening measures have been implemented, the fear of catastrophic failure persists. If the Mullaperiyar Dam were to collapse, the immediate and most devastating impact would be flooding of the downstream areas. The Periyar River, which the dam impounds, would be released with tremendous force, causing a massive surge of water to flow downstream. The districts of Ernakulam, Idukki, Kottayam and Alappuzha in Kerala would be most affected. The Idukki reservoir located downstream might temporarily hold back some of the floodwaters. However, the capacity of the Idukki reservoir would be quickly overwhelmed, leading to a spillover and subsequent flooding of the lower areas. Towns like Thodupuzha and Moonar could face severe inundation. The water surge could reach the district within a few hours, leading to widespread destruction. The low-lying areas, including parts of Kochi, could be submerged, causing loss of life and property on a massive scale. The districts like Alappuzha and Kottayam, being downstream of Ernakulam, would also experience severe flooding. The backwaters of Ernakulam could swell, leading to the displacement of thousands of people. The sudden release of water would likely to catch many people off guard, leading to a significant loss of life. The densely populated region downstream would be the hardest hit, with thousands of people potentially losing their lives within hours. The destruction of homes, businesses, infrastructure and agricultural lands would result in economic losses amounting to billions of dollars. Cities like Kochi could face unprecedented challenges as the floodwaters inundate roads, buildings and essential infrastructure. The destruction of hospitals, schools and government offices would severely disrupt the lives of survivors. The rural areas would also suffer greatly, with agricultural lands being washed away, livestock drowning and villages being obliterated. The loss of fertile land would have long-term implications for food security in the region. The collapse of Mullaperiyar Dam would lead to displacement of millions of people. Temporary shelters would need to be set up, and the logistics of providing food, water and medical care to such a large number of displaced persons would be daunting. The social and psychological impact on the affected population would be immense, with many people losing their homes, livelihoods and loved ones. The government would have to establish numerous relief camps to house the displaced population. These camps would likely be overcrowded, leading to a potential health crisis due to inadequate sanitation and the spread of diseases. Rehabilitating the affected population would be a long-term process, involving the reconstruction of homes, schools, and hospitals. The emotional trauma experienced by the survivors would require sustained psychological support. The environmental impact of a dam collapse would be catastrophic. The sudden release of such a large volume of water would cause severe erosion of riverbanks, leading to the destruction of natural habitats. The flora and fauna in the region, particularly the ecosystems in the Western Ghats, would be severely affected. The Western Ghats, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, is home to many endemic species of plants and animals. Flooding caused by a dam collapse would destroy these habitats, leading to the extinction of some species. The floodwaters would likely carry with them a significant amount of debris, including hazardous materials from industrial sites and sewage. This would contaminate the water source, leading to a public health crisis in the affected areas. The flooding would result in the destruction of vast tracts of agricultural land. The state of Kerala, which relies heavily on agriculture, would face severe economic losses. Crops like paddy, coconut, rubber and spices, which are vital to the state's economy, would be destroyed, leading to a sharp decline in agricultural output. Farmers, particularly smallholders, would be the hardest hit, losing not only their crops but also their fertile topsoil that sustains their livelihoods. The loss of income would push many into poverty, exacerbating the socio-economic challenges in the region. The destruction of agricultural lands would disrupt the supply chains, leading to shortage of essential commodities in the market. This could result in inflation, further straining the economy. Kerala, often referred to as God's own country, is a major tourist destination. The flooding and subsequent destruction of infrastructure would have a devastating impact on the tourism industry. The loss of heritage sites, hotels and natural attractions would lead to a sharp decline in tourist arrivals. The tourism industry is a significant contributor to Kerala's economy, providing employment to millions of people. The loss of revenue from tourism would have ripple effect on the state's economy, leading to job losses and reduced income for many families. The recovery of tourism sector would take years, if not decades. Rebuilding the infrastructure and restoring the natural beauty of the region would require substantial investment and time. The collapse of the dam would cause extensive damage to the infrastructure, including roads, bridges, railways, and power lines. The transportation network would be severely affected, hampering rescue and relief efforts. The damage to power lines and substations would lead to widespread blackouts, further complicating the situation. The cost of rebuilding the damaged infrastructure would be enormous. The state and central governments would need to allocate substantial resources for reconstruction, diverting funds from other essential services. The disruption of transportation and power supply would lead to an economic slowdown, affecting industries, businesses, and daily life in the region. The long-term economic impact could be felt across various sectors. The sudden and violent nature of a dam collapse would lead to widespread trauma among the affected population. Survivors would face the psychological impact of losing loved ones, homes, and livelihoods. The mental health consequences of such a disaster would be profound and long-lasting. Providing psychological support to the affected population would be crucial in the aftermath of the disaster. Counseling services, support groups, and mental health professionals would need to be mobilized to address the mental health crisis. The displacement and the loss of communities could lead to social disintegration. Flooding would likely to lead to a public health crisis with the spread of waterborne diseases like cholera, dysentery, and typhoid. The overcrowded relief camps would be breeding grounds for diseases, exacerbating the situation. The healthcare infrastructure in the affected areas would be overwhelmed by the sudden influx of patients. Hospitals and clinics would need additional resources and personnel to cope with the crisis. Implementing preventive measures such as vaccination campaigns and sanitation initiatives would be essential to prevent the spread of diseases. However, the logistical challenges in reaching the affected population would be significant. The Mullaperiyar has been a source of tension between the states of Kerala and Tamil Nadu for decades. The collapse of the dam would like to exacerbate these tensions, leading to legal and political battles over responsibility and compensation. The affected population and the state of Kerala could seek legal redress, demanding compensation from Tamil Nadu for the damages caused by the dam collapse. The legal battles could be protracted and contentious, further straining interstate relations. Political fallout from the dam collapse would lead to a loss of trust in the government and its institutions. Public anger and frustration could lead to protests, demand for accountability, and political instability. The scale of the disaster would likely to attract international attention with offers of aid and assistance from various countries and organizations. The Indian government would need to coordinate the relief efforts, ensuring that aid reaches the affected population in a timely and collective manner. Coordinating the influx of international aid would be a complex task, requiring the efficient logistics and communication. The government would need to ensure that aid is used effectively and transparently. The handling of disaster by the Indian government would be closely watched by the international community. Effective management of the crisis could enhance India's reputation on the global stage, while mismanagement could lead to criticism and loss of credibility. Given the catastrophic consequences of a dam collapse, it is imperative to take preventive measures to strengthen the Mullaperiyar Dam. Modern engineering techniques such as reinforcing the structure with concrete, installing advanced monitoring systems and conducting regular safety audits would enhance the dams. Implementing seismic retrofits would be crucial to ensure that the dam can withstand earthquakes. Strengthening the foundation and adding shock-absorbing materials would reduce the risk of structural failure. One of the primary concerns about the Mullaperiyar Dam is the high water level maintained by Tamil Nadu for irrigation purposes. Reducing the water level in the reservoir would reduce the pressure on the dam and minimize the risk of collapse. The collapse of Mullaperiyar Dam would be a disaster of unprecedented scale, with far-reaching consequences for the people, environment, and economy of Kerala and beyond. While the likelihood of such a catastrophe may seem remote, the potential impact underscores the need for proactive measures to prevent such an event. Strengthening the dam, reducing water levels, improving disaster preparedness, and fostering cooperation between Kerala and Tamil Nadu are essential steps to mitigate the risk. The Mullaperiyar Dam is not just a relic of past. It is a ticking time bomb that requires urgent attention to ensure the safety and well-being of millions of people. Thank you.